Welcome everyone to the Brandon Kirk Show. I'm Brandon Kirk, and in today's episode, I'm going to want to talk to you about something, and we're going to discuss some very good reasons why you might want to consider getting a GED instead of sitting 4 years in high school. Now, unless you want to be an engineer, a doctor, a scientist, or an attorney, you might want to consider getting a GED instead of sitting for 4 years in school. If you want to join the military or you want to go to a non-Ivy League college, a GED is a good enough diploma. Okay, the only people who have ever asked me to see my high school diploma or even asked if I had gotten through high school was a military recruiter and the admissions people at the local college. Other than that, no employer has ever asked to see my high school diploma, nor have they asked if I even graduated high school. And here's some reasons you might want to consider getting a GED. Number one, you're an intelligent person, but traditional school just does not work for you. And I get that. A lot of people just cannot work in the traditional school environment. The next one is you're more of a hands-on learner. You like to see and do and put your hands on stuff. You're very intelligent, but learning from a book is just not your style. I get that. Next one is you can't stand your high school peers, or they're bullying you, or you think they're a bunch of jerks and you don't want to spend extra time with them. And that makes sense. If you want to get away from these people, then you might want to consider getting a GED. And I can honestly say I wish I'd gotten my GED when I was 16 and skipped the last 2 years of high school, because I literally learned nothing in those 2 years. It was a waste of my time. Now, the GED test, if you want to take it, it's basically comprised of four subjects. And you can take each one of the four tests one at a time and on different dates. It doesn't all have to be done at once. The four subjects are language arts, you got math, science, and social studies. And you can take the test at your own pace, and you only have to study one subject at a time when you're getting ready for your test. I think that's pretty great. But I have a strategy for you. If you are in high school and you want thinking about, hey, I want to get my GED, my strategy is, number one, stay in school. Don't just drop out. I want you to stay in school while you're studying for your GED. If you just drop out, then your motivation for getting your GED will quickly be replaced by your need to bring in an income. And if that's the case, the chances of you actually going out and finishing your GED could be pretty low. And then you're not a person with a GED, you're just a dropout. We want to avoid that. So stay in school while you study for your GED. Spend your free time studying for each test. Be careful who you discuss your plans with, because friends, teachers, and other people are going to try to talk you out of doing what you want to do. Okay? Pass all four tests. Get the GED diploma in your hand. Then and only then, leave high school. And once you've left high school, if you then want to go to a trade school, a junior college, or a college, you'll already be ahead of your peers. While they're stuck in class, you could be going to a trade school or working on an apprenticeship, actually getting hands-on real-life experience. So that's something to consider. Now, with a GED, you can go to college or a trade school. And if you want to work in the trades, like being an electrician, a plumber, a mechanic, an HVAC technician, there is a shortage of people in this country to work in the trades right now. There's a huge shortage. And that's because for the last several decades, the big push in our country has been, ooh, you got to go to college. You got to go to college. So we need to think about that. Well, okay, I could go to college and then end up with a bunch of debt and no guarantee that, you know, that my college degree is actually going to get me a job. And people act like going to college and coming out with a bunch of debt is the gold standard, and somehow you not having a degree is a bad thing. Well, degrees are actually overrated. But here's the best part. I know plumbers, electricians, carpet cleaners, and HVAC technicians who easily make six figures. I mean, I do. They have no student debt, no student loans to pay back. And these people can make as much or more than most doctors with much less liability. Meanwhile, your high school peers, they've wasted 2 years of their life and they have tons of student debt and no real skills. And you're out there killing it already because you choose to do something better with your time. So unless your chosen profession requires it, you don't need a high school diploma or a college degree to earn a very good living. I hope that helps you guys. Have a great day. Thanks a lot. Catch you next time.